रश्मि उर्ध्वार देशे पुणे महाराष्ट्र, आप पिछले 60 सालों से ऑटोमोटिव तथा आरएनडी प्रोफेशनल हैं। आपने एमिशन मेजरमेंट में योगदान देकर भारत की पहली एमिशन लेबोरेटरी स्थापित करने में महत्वपूर्ण भूमिका निभाई।
Thank you so much for your time as always. A little on, you know, how ARAI, because ARAI seems to be the most important mediator between the government and the end customers, the OEs, the ancillaries, when it comes to homologation. So, with the flurry of activity at ARAI, you would have, of course, had some sense of how the industry is going forward. Is it optimistic? Is the slowdown for real? You know, how is it really shaping up from the ARAI's perspective?
I've seen the industry from very close quarters.
Right.
I've seen the pain which has gone into designing new products which will be not only BS6 compliant but also in terms of passenger car crash compatible. So we are going into future where consumer is going to get very safe products and also environmentally friendly products. So I see no hesitation that this technology will add value to the consumer and the market. There's no need for any kind of apprehension whatsoever that consumers should have adopting this technology.
Right. From the homologation perspective, BS6 is, you know, near rollout now. We know that Ashok Leyland has been, you know, certified for the high heavy duty trucks. Other OEMs are to follow. What are the specific measures you are taking from ARAI's perspective to ensure that it's a seamless transition and it attains the end objective?
At ARAI, the testing and homologation is quite comprehensively done.
Right.
When it comes to BS6 compliance, at the heavy duty cycle, we do the engine testing as well as at the vehicle level. There is a real driving emissions requirement which will ensure that not just at the level 3 level but also in real driving emissions the performance will be at par. That also poses some kind of requirement for the consumer that these are high technology vehicles. They have to be therefore used appropriately,
right,
handled appropriately and maintained so.
Right.
So that's my take on handling these products for the Indian market.
Right.
And also I would say that there's always some hitches, some glitches anywhere. But I think the manufacturers are gearing up for service network. There's another thing which is coming up is upscaling of the service network, which is happening parallelly.
Right. The manufacturers made a very valid point. They said, give us the end target in terms of the emission reductions that they want to achieve, but let us have the freedom of choosing the technological path through which we want to reach that. At ARAI, you're geared up with all these technologies in terms of homologation and certifying, you know, the right technology for the right emission standard. Do you feel, you know, there is a scope for giving manufacturers the freedom to decide which technology has to be used? You know, is it really practically possible to allow that leeway?
Of course it is possible, and the regulations BS6 for example is truly agnostic to any kind of fuel. BS6 has a provision for petrol, diesel, bio diesel, ethanol, methanol and whatnot.
Right.
So all those provisions have been made in the regulations, and therefore I see that the manufacturers do have a freedom. But along with it comes also the infrastructure. So when we are talking about methanol as the possible fuel, obviously with it comes the infrastructure related to methanol distribution.
Right.
Also for ethanol blending. We can't leave it for the retailers to do it.
Right.
It has to be done in the refineries to ensure the correctness,
right,
of composition and quality of petrol.
Right.
And that is what is the demand from manufacturing.
Right. You recently launched about the Center of Excellence for E-Mobility. A little on that, you know, how different is homologating an EV compared to a BS6 vehicle? And when you talk about EV in the sense of having the entire ecosystem ready, which is not the case at the moment, from the homologation perspective, are you ready on that front?
Of course. This center was conceived 5 years ago. Therefore, we were well within time to get ready for not just homologation, innovation, but also for the development.
Right.
For ecosystem to develop, we have the infrastructure in terms of charging stations. So the protocol development, standardization, as well as having the prototypes to be tested and certified has been going on. On the vehicle side, obviously, the electric vehicle homologation additionally involves some safety checks and certain performance checks. So the center also caters for all these requirements. And then the third angle is, of course, component development, critical component development such as motors, e-motors, controllers. So we not only have the testing facilities, but also simulation networks and the capability of designing these products, and also sometimes optimization to cater to the larger vehicle sectors. So that capability exists.
Right. Since the OE customers land at your end and, you know, you certify them for technology like BS6, for the April 2020 rollout, do you think the entire industry is already certified? How many of the stakeholders of the industry really need to come to you to comply with this technology? At what stage are we right now?
Yeah, most of the manufacturers, we have a very detailed discussion about what is their action plan, because we would like to avoid the last minute rush, thereby denying the opportunity for manufacturers to come and do the homologation. So a very structured planning has gone into giving them slots.
Right.
I can foresee that all the manufacturers will get ready with at least the fast-moving products and the vehicles to be ready on the deadline.
Right.
And then as a strategy, they will move the other other remaining products also.
Right.
So as far as our workload is concerned, we have created more than one set. There are about three distinct teams that handle homologation requirements. So at any given point of time, three or four manufacturers can come to us to do the testing and homologation.
Right.
We have also shortened the testing time and processing time to cater with this large workload. And we are very, very happy that the teams are performing exceedingly well.
Right, I'll end it at that. Thank you so much.
Thank you.